These little pieces I have just played are very enjoyable for me. It's a kind of reminiscence of the antecessor to the guitar, the lute. They are from Polish composers like Albert Dlugaraj, the first, and Mr. Jakub Polak-Rajs. The pieces I'm going to play . The composer that I'm going to play now is a Catalonian composer whose name is Ferdinand Sor. He was also administrator of Napoleon and a composer for a lot of other groups of instruments but guitar. Miguel Llobet was also a Catalonian composer like Ferdinand Saur, and he arranged a lot of traditional folk songs of Catalonia for the guitar. Federico Moreno Torroba is an outstanding composer for zarzuela in Spain. And most of his music for guitar reflects also this zarzuela influence.
Thank you.
Manuel de Falla composed a fantastic piece whose name is Dance of the Miller, and this is a transcription for guitar of it. Agustin Barrios Mangoré was a Paraguayan composer whose outstanding way of using the guitar and his own possibilities make him understand the way of using it in Brazil, Uruguay, Argentina, and other South American countries. Among these beautiful pieces, we count one of the most outstanding parts of the repertoire. My grandfather, José Pierri Sapere, was the son of Italian immigrants in Uruguay, and he was living in a little town in the interior of the country. And he became an amateur guitarist. And amateur guitarist for playing mostly what interested him in his young years, that was the folkloric music. And he became composer with some friends of him also. And some of his compositions became very known some years later. And now I'm going to play his music. The Brazilian composer Heitor Villa-Lobos was, in his young years, a pop musician. He was playing in the streets, and he was playing choros. The choros, which is the name, the Brazilian name for the street serenades under a window. And this choro number one for guitar is probably a resume of a lot of experiences of choro that Villa-Lobos developed in his young years. Thank you. Leo Brouwer is a Cuban composer that is now the director of Cordoba, Spain Orchestra. And Leo has been contributing to the guitar repertoire with an enormous and fantastic production in several styles, always using folkloric influences or themes or rhythms, or making a lot of experiences, mainly in the 70s, and also some minimal music. In reality now, he's a very free composer in style and in tools and in everything, and has been a major protagonist of the 20th century guitarist life. Thank you. next piece is going to be something that all the others before were make me think. It's a piece I was learning with my colleagues in the college, and it was a very nice experience to try it at the guitar from a disc from Vinicius de Moraes and Toquinho.